We got something that is new, that is true. We got something just for you today.
Safe to say they liked us.
It sure sounded like it.
We're a pretty great audience.
Great? Did I hear someone say great? Then you must have been talking about me. As a matter of fact, kid, we weren't. We were talking about the audience. Not me?
Oh, brother.
You know, kid, you better be careful. You're gonna need a bigger head size.
Right, right. Go ahead and laugh. You're just jealous. Can I help it if I'm good-looking, talented, and modest?
Kid, don't you think that some of that applause might have been for the rest of us?
Yeah, they seemed to like all of us.
Well, don't get me wrong. I'm sure the audience appreciates the rest of you, too. After all, where would Bruce be without the E Street Band? Where would Mick be without the Stones? And where would I be without my support group?
Support group? I think we've been insulted.
Yeah, let's get out of here before his head explodes.
Yeah, let's go.
Come on, kid. We got another number to do. You don't want to keep your fans waiting.
I knew you'd understand, Ryan.
Yeah, right.
Get off of me. Wait, hey, hey, hey.
Sunshine and make the man go blind. You never can tell what you will do, but this time you wind up feeling so fine. Some people seem to have a knack. They bring you up or leave you flat. You never can tell who's playing, so keep so tight.
I can't believe it either.
Three extra bows.
Hi, I'm back.
Uh-oh. Here comes the ego that ate Chicago. Let's go, Stacy.
Sorry.
Hey, great composers. I'll be in that book someday.
You know, kid, you might be right. I was just thinking about how much you remind me of a great composer I'm reading about now.
Really? Who?
Mozart. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Oh, I've heard of him. What songs did you write again?
Lots of them, kid. They weren't exactly songs. They were arias, operas, and concertos.
Oh, but I'm sure I could write a couple of those, too.
Mozart was a genius, buddy.
Oh, well, then that must be why I remind you so much of him. A genius. I like the sound of that.
A genius. I'm
Brian, why did you have to tell him that? Now his head's gonna get even bigger, if that's possible.
Well, he didn't let me finish what I was gonna say. As well as being a genius, Mozart had a big ego. And that's why the kid reminded me of him.
That's for sure.
Genius. Genius, just like Mozart.
That lovely little sonata you played for us last evening.
Oh yes, do.
It's not a sonata, ladies. It's sonaria.
Whatever.
Please don't embarrass me with another standing ovation.
Who's that?
That's a Mozart. Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
The composer. He's wonderful. Everyone knows he's a genius.
Genius? Did I hear someone say genius?
I see you heard of me. Wolfgang Amadeus is the name. Composing is the game. But you can call me Wolfie.
Wolfie?
Perhaps the boy wonder will charm us with a one more performance.
Oh, yes, do.
Well, I guess it wouldn't be fair to deprive you all of my genius.
Next number, I would like to play Sonata in D major, Opus 4, blindfolded.
Did you like it? It was nothing, really.
You're too modest, Wolfie.
I know.
Don't.
you all for having the great taste to idolize me. If you're very, very good, I would let all of you kiss my hand before I leave. Maestro, haven't you been working on a new composition? Perhaps we could hear it. Don't bother. After all, once you've heard the best, why listen to the rest?
One thing you can say about the Wolfie, he isn't alone a self-esteemer.
It's getting a little stuffy in here.
We'd better be leaving, Maestro.
That's a good idea. Come back tomorrow and I'll play you my new composition.
Can you imagine anyone leaving a room in the great Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart is in it?
May I give you a word of advice, Amadeus?
You give me advice? Don't make me laugh.
You will find with age that the praise is a sweeter when it is a not the coming from one's own the mouth. The man who blows his own the horn eventually finds himself playing in an orchestra of a one. Good day, boy wonder.
Excuse me, Ryan. Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
When you said that I reminded you of Mozart, were you talking about my talent or my ego?
Tell you the truth, kid, a little bit of both.
I thought so. You know, the maestro was right.
Hmm?
He said, a guy who plays his own horn will end up in a one-man band.
What are you talking about?
Well, it was something like that. Anyway, I think I like a band that's a little bigger.
Good, because that's what we've got. Let's knock 'em dead, genius.
All right.
Let's go.
When I think about that fortune crew, I was taking you for granted. And now didn't know there's no future when you're walking out that door.
It's hard to go back then, but what I know now.
And now we can't even learn the song.
Maybe we shouldn't do this song.
There's nothing wrong with the song. If we only learn to play it right.
Who's not playing it right?
For starters, I think you're hitting some sour notes on your sax, kid.
Hey, don't blame me. I'm not the one who blew up the amplifiers.
Oh, you saying this is all my fault?
Yes.
We have been asking you to turn down the volume all day.
Oh, the volume was just fine. It's those crummy amplifiers.
No, it's you. You put it on the
head, and if you don't
stop arguing, everybody. Take
Lucy, stay out of this.
No, I don't want it.
And another thing, I don't like the clothes you've been wearing on stage.
Me either.
Then make your own.
We do.
Boys, what do they know?
Now that we're discussing things, I think that I should do the announcements on stage.
What are you talking about? That's my job.
I don't remember voting on that, Ryan.
I think we should all get to do them.
Yeah!
And if I'm going to be front and center, I need a whole new look.
You sure do.
Hey, hold it. Well, we're still talking to one another. Let's try out what's left of our sound system.
I don't want to do it.
Get ready. One, two, three, four. Great saxophone work, kid.
Yeah, terrific.
Thanks, but I think there's one thing you should know.
What's that?
I wasn't playing my saxophone. It broke during the number.
You weren't playing the sax? Stacy, you...
No.
Then who was?
Say that I have my ways. Yes, you could say that.
Maybe he's a thief.
Most thieves wouldn't stop to play a song on the saxophone.
Where did you come from?
See, he broke in through the roof.
Higher than that is where I hang my hat.
But the only place higher than that is the sky.
You're close.
Only Santa Claus comes from the sky.
Yes. Nice man, Santa. Keeps awful busy with his work.
You know Santa? What's your name?
Oh, Manny's the name I've been called.
Well, since it seems like you come from the sky, we'll call you Mr. Angel.
Yeah, that's me.
That's as good a name as Annie, I suppose.
So, what brings you here?
Well, it's my job to fly here and there, fixing the troubles in the air.
Boy, did you come to the right place. We can't agree on anything.
That's not true.
See what I mean?
You're not the only ones with this problem, you know. Since the time when the Earth was new, many's the different point of view. This one says black, that one says white, and each believes only he is right.
Come on, let's not burden this guy with our troubles. We don't even know who he is.
Yeah, we can work them out ourselves.
Wait! Before you all run pell-mell, I've got a little tale to tell. What I've got to say, well, it might help you. When next you play. A little boy's dreaming after school, moving his feet to the beat of the music in his heart. He's gotta make his dream come true. His eyes burning hot, if it takes all he's got. He says, reach out for that star. I can feel it, I know it's not too far. If I could, I'd find out where you are. Together we could reach that star. Your name in lights, shining only in your eyes. One thin dime in your pocket. You think about it every single day, and the parts you're gonna play, and the things you wanna say. Moving your feet to the beat of that music in your heart. Your eyes burning hot. If it takes all you've got, just reach out for that star. I can feel it, I know it's not too far. If I could, I'd find out where you are. Because the things inside of you can make your dreams come true. If you keep reaching for that star.
Problems now, Mr. Angel.
Where I come from, we have an old saying. What looks like a big feast might only be small potatoes.
Yeah, but we just...
Look, I've seen Cain fight Abel. I've seen the Hatfields argue with the McCoys. I was even at the Alamo. And all those things had one thing in common. They were avoidable.
But how?
Relief is through belief.
Huh?
Right now, you don't believe that you can get along, just like Ryan. You don't believe you can play the saxophone.
Yeah, but I can't play the sax.
You're wrong. Here, take this. Put one finger here, one there, one here, and one here. Now put your lips here, and blow.
See, I told you.
Yes, yes, so you say. But now I want you to play as though you've been doing it every day. Believe in yourself, Ryan. Think positive thoughts. Now blow.
Oh, right, you did it, Mr. Angel.
No. Ryan did it. I just gave him a little help. And now that I've given you a start, to make that sax really talk, you must do your part.
So, all we have to do is believe in ourselves and work together, and we can happily be together again?
To that question, I needn't guess. The answer is yes, yes, yes.
But what about our blown-out amplifiers?
Yeah.
What are we going to do about that?
Will you answer that phone? It's for me.
Stop kidding around. It hasn't even rung.
Hello? It is for you.
Thank you. Yes? Well, what's the answer? Oh, you will be able to make it. Very good. It's the company I work for. They're sending over some help. Thank you. Make it soon. Make it real soon.
Thank you.
so well together, just like Mr. Angel said.
Yeah, we owe Mr. Angel a big thank you.
Mm-hmm. Well, it looks like we're gonna owe it to him for a long time. He's gone.
Where is he?
He's gone.
He's not at the soda fountain.
He's not backstage. Negative in the storeroom. The table area is clean.
Hey, did you notice he has us all working together trying to find him?
Yeah.
Now that's cooperation.
He was really nice. He's saying really nice. I miss him.
Hey, look. His saxophone.
And the note. It's from Mr. Angel.
My duty is done here, so the Fixits and I take leave of you now and return to the sky. When problems arise, you need not despair, since now you can solve them with friendship and care. You've all got the power to carry the tune. Use your skills well, and I'll see you all soon.
What a great guy.
Gosh, I can't believe we didn't even get to say goodbye to him.
Well, maybe he'll come back.
Yeah, he left his saxophone.
And a lot more. He left behind a part of himself that will always stay with us.
Wow! The ink on his note is disappearing!
We're on our own now, guys. Let's do a good job.
Yeah!
When I know.
Because it so happens I have 10 free tickets for putting those posters up. Step right up to the counter. Hey. Hey. Oh. Rich. Hey, honey.
Can we get in line early?
This is going to be outstanding. Hey, kid, you got a ticket yet?
No, I haven't.
Hurry, Riley's giving them away.
I know, I just don't feel like going.
But I thought you were so excited about seeing Patti LaBelle.
Yeah. Well, I got plans for that night.
But this is the event of the year.
I can't make it, okay? Can we just drop it and go play some music?
Heartaches can bring one day.
Now, kid, you seem upset. Is there something wrong?
I'm sorry I got all wound up earlier. It's just that Billy Blaster.
Who, the guy opening for Patti LaBelle?
Yeah. I never told him, but he's my brother.
Billy Blaster's your brother?
All my life.
You never mentioned having a brother. You guys don't get along?
Yeah. Well, we used to. We haven't spoken to each other in 5 years.
Wow, that's a long time to carry on a feud. You know, Renee and I usually settle ours in a day. Okay, maybe 2 or 3 weeks tops?
It wasn't a feud that split us apart. My brother left home 5 years ago. No note. No goodbye. Nothing. I came home one day and he was gone. He's been gone ever since.
That's terrible.
I never understood why he left. Sometimes I just think it's best to try and forget.
But aren't you curious to see him?
I guess I am. But I know it would hurt, too.
Hey, kid, you want a malted or something?
No, thanks. I just need time to figure it out.
Well, look, if you need anything, you've got family right here.
Thanks, guys.
In a world full of people, you can lose sight of it, and the darkness inside you can make you feel so small. But I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show me your true colors. True are beautiful like the rainbow. Show me a smile, and don't be unhappy, can't remember when I last saw you laughing. If this war makes you crazy and you've taken all you can bear, you call me up, cause you know I'll be there. And I see your true colors shining through. I see your true colors, and that's why I love you. So don't be afraid to let them show me your true colors. True colors are beautiful like a rainbow.
Toy store.
Yeah. I remember my dad buying me my first baseball glove. Right here.
So you live here in town?
Oh, used to.
Look at the train set.
Yeah, my brother and I, we...
Your brother and you what?
Oh, nothing. My brother and I used to have one just like it.
Oh, by the way, I'm Renee.
Good to meet you. Billy Blaster.
Yeah, I know. You're that great comedian.
You've heard of me? Hey, well, my friends call me Mr. Last. Now, what do you get when you pin a badge on a Frank letter? Huh?
I don't know.
A police dog.
So, do you miss living here anymore?
Ah, nah. I've gotten to travel all over, performing in every state, including the state of confusion.
Could I ask a favor of you?
Hey, I'm broke. But go ahead.
Well, is
See, I have this friend who used to be a really big fan of yours.
Used to be? I thought my act was getting better.
Well, it really wasn't your act that he was attracted to.
We'll fix that. I'll give your friend a few free tickets, free, mind you, to my show.
That's really nice of you, but what this friend needs is to talk for a while with his brother.
Your friend of Rahsaan? How's he doing? What's happening?
I really think you should find that out for yourself.
I can't.
Listen, it hurt him a lot when you left. He's been trying to deny to himself that he ever had a brother. His best friends didn't even know you existed until today. Look, if you don't want to lose him forever, you'd better go see him.
You don't understand.
I think I do. And this time it's no joke.
I know it's no joke. I can't. I can't. I just can't. I can't.
I can't. Okay, try not to be so stubborn about seeing him. He is your brother.
That's the problem. He's my brother. Why did he leave me? I can't figure it out.
Come on, you know how families are. Everybody battles with each other from time to time.
But what if he never wants to see me again?
Come on, you don't really believe that.
Part of me is afraid. I don't know if I still love him.
Contact. Contact.
Wish me luck on finding my brother.
Good luck, kid. You're looking great, kid. How you doing?
Okay.
Coming to the show tomorrow? Hey, you remember that secret handshake we used to do when we were kids? How'd that go? Hey,
Here's some sodas. We'll be in the storeroom if you need us.
I guess I deserve whatever bad thoughts you have toward me, Rahsaan. If I could make up all the lost time, I would. But all I can say is I'm sorry.
I don't understand. You were my best friend. And then poof, you were gone. Why?
I didn't want to leave you, Rahsaan. Dad wanted me to follow in his footsteps. Work in some factory. I wanted to get out into the world, do something for myself. Be my own man. I don't know. Looking back, maybe he was right. Here I am 5 years later, still struggling as an opening act and barely making ends meet. But at least I'm happy because I'm my own man, my own boss, and I'm doing something I believe in. Dad could never understand that.
But why didn't you keep in touch with me?
I couldn't. Dad thought that you follow in my footsteps and he wouldn't even let me contact you.
Really?
Really. Funny thing is, he ended up giving you more leeway anyhow. I hear you with a great band doing your thing, and I'm sure he let you do that because he didn't want to lose you like he lost me.
I never thought about it that way. But can't you and Dad get together again and start talking?
I think we can. I'm going to try.
All that time you've been gone, I've tried so hard to forget about you. I couldn't. I missed you so much.
Hey, not a day's gone by when I didn't think about you, Rahsaan. Not one. Look, it's been a long 5 years, and I tell you what, if you can forgive me, I'll be the best brother from now on in the whole world.
Promise?
I promise. Let's seal it with a secret handshake, okay?
I love you.
I love you too.
Never say never.
No, don't change your mind, baby.
this?
You won't believe it.
You're right. If it's one of your new inventions, we won't believe it.
Looks like ice cream to me.
It's more than just that, Connie. It's a new flavor I just invented. Now, come on, everyone. Go ahead. Try it. Tell me what you think.
It's kind of a funny color for ice cream.
Why? I like green stripes and pink dots.
Riley, maybe you better tell us what flavor it's supposed to be before we try it.
At least give us a clue.
Listen, now, it's all natural ingredients, and it's gonna be the best thing you ever tasted if you just come on and try it. Let's go. Come on.
Looks kind of funny, but, you know, maybe it's good.
Well, then you try first, Ryan.
All right.
Mm. Yeah? Yeah? I knew it. I'm a genius ahead of my time.
I mean, wow.
Unbelievable.
Completely scrumptious.
Nothing to it.
Congratulations, Riley.
Riley, you have got to make this a permanent addition to the place menu.
Well, what is it called, Riley?
Well, it's one thing I haven't even thought of yet.
This is too good to go nameless.
Riley, if you want this ice cream to go anywhere, it's all in the name.
You know, Richie's right. Names are important. You have to sound right.
Hey, maybe we could help you think of one.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Dictionary, paper, and some pencils.
And lots of erasers.
I'm gonna go to the library and do a little research.
And I think I'll do a little research about Nick's ice cream parlor. Taste testing all 31 flavors. Finding a name is gonna be so much fun, right, kid?
But it's really hard coming up with the right name.
Yeah.
I know.
Rocky Road Warrior. Or maybe Rocky Road 5, the sequel.
Just trying to help.
I knew this wasn't going to be easy.
The name has to mean something. It has to make you feel the flavor.
Well, what does it feel like to you, Stace?
Soft and dreamy. How about romantic summer supreme? Who's going to order that? Yuck.
None of these names sound right.
Isn't it funny how our names fit us so well?
Yeah, I wonder how our parents came up with our names.
Yeah, they did such a great job. Maybe we should ask them.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Then maybe we'll know how to name Riley's ice cream.
Yeah, you know, I really think we're on the right track. Kit, where are you going?
I gotta get home and finish some homework. Yeah, that's it.
Homework? No homework.
Yeah, I've gotta check some math for my English test. No, I have to check some English for my math test. Well, really, I just gotta really get
Kit.
Out of here.
I just thought of something. We've always just called you the Kid. I mean, that couldn't be what your parents named you.
Yeah, I bet you've got a great name, and all this time we've never known what it is.
Yeah, what is your name, Kid?
Well, that's kind of my secret. And gosh, it's really getting late, and I...
Wait, Kid. People's names aren't meant to be secrets, then we wouldn't know what to call one another.
Well, it's my secret, Renee. And I guess sometimes secrets just aren't meant to be told to anyone.
I can't name it, but the kid's got a problem. That's it.
What's it?
His name. We find it out, and we find out what's bothering him. Come on.
What's it to you? What's it to you? You don't care for me. Never mind what you said, no. Suddenly you coming round again. Whoa. And you wanna know how I've been? What's it to you? What's it to your eye? You don't care for me or do you forget? What's it to you? I see through your eye. You only want something that you can't. Hoping I can resist. Oh, and now you wanna know who she is. What's it to you? What's it to you? You don't care for me or do you forget? What's it to you? I see through your eye. You only want something that you cannot get.
My name's my secret, and I'm keeping it.
We're not snooping, Kid. We're only trying to help.
We thought you wanted to talk this problem out.
The only problem I have is my name. All you guys have normal names. My name is different.
You mean it's hard to pronounce?
Not exactly. In this country, my name just sounds strange because it's an African name. I was named after my great-grandfather. He was a tribal chief.
Well, you know, Kid, most people are named after important people in their family's past. A lot of names, ours included, come from foreign origins.
Now, our ancestors are the people who made America great.
Yeah, this country was founded by people from other lands. The first people in America were the Pilgrims, and they came from England.
Hey, our mother's from England. As a matter of fact, I was named after our great aunt who was married into British nobility.
Is that why Dad called you Princess?
No, Stacy. What I'm trying to say is we all have names that were specially chosen for us because they were names our families were proud of.
Names with meaning.
Prime.
Tradition.
And history.
Going on deep inside your heart.
Always something.
I guess you're right. Names are something to be proud of. My name is Rahsaan.
Rahsaan. That's a beautiful name.
Yeah, but Rahsaan doesn't think so. What are we gonna do?
Riley, set me up.
Will it be, partner?
Your best and make it good.
Aha, I got just the trick. The latest addition to the place menu.
Hey, your new ice cream. You know, it really is good.
It's got a smooth flavor, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Kind of nutty, too.
Yeah, real nutty.
You know, the kids, they came up with a name that really expresses its special kind of crazy qualities.
Crazy is right.
In fact, you know, we're having a naming celebration today. Right now.
The place is proud to present Touchdown!
Riley's newest flavor, Touchdown!
Special enough we could think of for Riley's special ice cream.
Thanks, guys. I guess this name stuff has really been making me act strange.
No different than usual. Just kidding, Rahsaan.
I guess you're right. I guess my name is something to be proud of. And I thank you guys for helping me learn that.
Forget it, Rahsaan.
You know, I may have my great-grandfather's name, but I also have something he never had.
What's that?
My own ice cream flavor.
And
great friends like you
guys. Aw, Rahsaan, you're still a kid to us.
All right. Yeah.
Okay.
Riley, it's you, Riley.
Let's go.
Same trap, this thing is happening to us all.